How many of you have already transformed?
We don't.
It's an ongoing.
We don't know.
Yeah.
There was a client. So that was basically Netherlands-based client. All the government organization handling the metros there. So they were into, I won't say tradition, but they had some different model. They will give requirements, disappear for 1 month. So slowly I try to bring them to agile.
Okay. How many of you are agile coach here? So what comes in your mind after reading this?
Adoption happens.
Sustaining is difficult.
So he tried and failed, is that the case?
Yes.
Okay.
He's following
the agenda. The first line, what it says?
Change is easy.
Sustaining is
difficult. Okay, so that's what. We can reach to a state, but that does not matter if we cannot continue that. We cannot sustain that, right? Do you feel, have you ever felt when you were in the agile transformation, when you were in part of that agile transformation, have you felt like this? Have you ever seen that some cases where people are saying that, yes, 2 years back, our team has been transformed, but what is the current state? No, again we fall back. Or this team has been transformation journey multiple times, 3 times, 4 times. Right? Anyone? Have you found that? No? Okay. So I will give you one thing. One of my engagement, right? That organization was in big organization level transformation journey. And what was happening in that case? They have identified in their case step by step. So not in a big bang approach. They thought that let's first do it of phase one, we will have this way. Then we will have that some more maturity level, so we will have that phase two and then phase three. I got to know about one of the team, so whom I have to start working with in my that engagement, that they are already in phase one. So sometime back, last year, they have been transformed, right? And when I started discussing with them, I found that they are not in phase one. What is the reason?
They relapse.
Okay. Why?
Because they didn't imbibe it to the extent that they should have been. They transformed their own culture to the extent. Maybe there was not enough buy-in, they were not consulted. Many factors.
Okay. Any other?
Not out practice.
Okay.
Management buying.
Management buying. So again, that was at organizational level, so management buying was there in that case. Yes, any other?
People left.
Yes. I found that entire team was totally new. Whoever was there, who has been transformed, is no more.
Some other company
transformed. And that was extreme, so entire team was new. But you will find that very soon it's getting diluted. Why? Because the new people is going to be joined, right? And there are lots of other issues as well. So that we will discuss also, right? So that's why we cannot stick with this entire transformation as a destination. So, we are transformed now, right? So that was the whole agenda of this talk. So before we start, why do we need? So if you can remember yesterday some talk where we were talking about before going to the transformation, right? You just think about why we want to, right? Why normally we opt for this agile transformation? What is the reason? Yeah, please. You all have raised your hand.
We want to react faster to changes. We want to be adaptable. We want better quality.
Okay, better quality. Okay, adaptable. Anything else?
Faster time.
Okay.
Current things are not working.
Why?
My boss wants change.
But my boss wants to change. Okay. That will be actually a disaster. If you don't want to change and your boss wants to change, okay, fine.
Some
anything
companies,
else?
Cool. Some companies want to follow because somebody is doing it.
Okay, that is really great. Okay. Anything from your side?
My neighbor is doing
that. It's okay. Like my competitors are implemented, so I want to.
Being more productive.
Business compulsion, right? Okay.
Changing requirements.
Good.
Because we want change. I don't want waterfall, I want something else.
I don't want waterfall. Why I don't want waterfall?
Because it's not working. I mean, most of the time.
It's not working, right? So that's the reason. Something which is there right now, whether it's waterfall or something else, is not working. I want to improve.
But right? There is one point. You know, the waterfall was working since last 20 years, but suddenly it didn't work.
So that's why I have not used that name, waterfall. Something which was there right now is not working. Whether it's waterfall, whatever. Right? So that is where we have to look at. Okay? What is this? Okay, anything else?
Chaos.
Right. And it's not only chaos. It's full of chaos. Right? And what represents here? So if you look at from your organization perspective, what are the things comes into your mind? Not only from the code perspective.
Lack of clarity.
Yeah.
Alignment.
Data center.
No clear path.
Yes. So it's not only depicts your technical things. It also depicts your process thing. There are also lots of chaos there. Right?
People are not aware of their responsibility.
Yes, they are not aware of, there are lots of assumptions in their mind. With that assumption, they do something, right? And again, it went to that same chaos, right? The process itself is not so clear, right? Or maybe it's so lengthy, lots of reason, right? And why it is important, this full of chaos, to get rid of this full of chaos, why it is important?
It's a objective.
What objective?
Everyone wants to be successful.
Simple and transparency.
Yeah, that's correct. But why we want to get rid of this chaos?
Because unless you get rid of your tail, you won't go away. That should be a piece.
It will surely aspire your progress.
So basically, if you look at from the organizational perspective, if you look at from product perspective, if you look at from your team perspective, or as an individual contributor perspective, right? We want to embrace that change, right? Which is coming from the business side, right? Maybe as a developer, I feel that entire code is messy. It's very difficult to make a small change, right? I'm finding that entire process itself is so lengthy that bringing one particular change till that actual implementation takes couple of months or more than that. There also we are not very sure. So basically, if you look at the transformation, when we think about these are the primary region, what is full of chaos, and then we want to impress the change. Right. And that's the reason we think about. Let's go for where? Go to the AI coaches.
Good.
Okay. So what we do? So we find that lots of people are already there in that race. Let's get into there. Right? So everybody is talking about what nowadays? What is very common? DevOps. So let's go for the DevOps. What is DevOps? Okay, fine. Do we have that automation tool? Yes. Provisioning tool, do we have? Yes, let's have it. We have the feedback loop or that monitoring tool? Yes. Let's start branding that we are DevOps. Right? Or if you look at from the technology perspective also, few years back, we are not, when that as a service has not been evolved, before that also everything was going fine, right? The moment that as a service came, what is that as a service?
That came even before that.
Yeah, right? No, but from the technology perspective, what came as a service?
Software.
Okay, but what was the concept?
Cloud.
The moment cloud came as a buzzword, everybody is in
cloud.
And if you will go and if you will ask, are you doing the software as a service? No, no, no. We are actually having our own private cloud. Was it not there earlier also? Yes, of course. So lots of time we see that what is going into the market. Let's get into there. Right? And if you will see that everybody is in this race, what happens? So if you look at agile adoption rate, it's quite high. And if you look at agile success rate, it's very rare, right? We will look for those case studies. And we will try to find out if there is a case study. And then later also we will have some doubts on that case study, right? Right? So only few finishes, and that's the reality. Long back, Kane has told that even more than 80% agile adoption is going as, getting as a failure. They're getting a failure, right? I don't know on what basis he got it, because some controversial interview also, lots of questions that have been raised on that. But of course, because he is talking to lots of people, he is seeing from his perspective, he is also finding that that is what the rate is. And if you have already been in this particular domain for a long time, probably you will also have that. You will align with his thought, right? So only few we will find that there are some examples where we are finding, yes, it has finished, and still we will have some questions on that. Well,
it's not the adoption that might have failed, okay. It's the practices that they might have adopted might have not changed because of the business compulsions. Overall, if you really look at it, the adoption might not have really changed. Only the practices you might have fallen back to the bad practices.
So how will you measure that success? That's the question, right? How will you measure the question? Success. That you have adopted something, you have transformed. How you will measure that, yes, you have done that. On what basis? Whether you are doing TDD is the measurement that you got a success?
See, some of the metrics.
Yes, of course.
Of course. Must be across various activities that we might
do. Definitely. Yeah. So I agree. So if that is the case, yes, of course. Then we can identify that success.
Yeah.
Correct. But still, if you look at the success rate, it will be very low. So what is the reason of success or failures? What is the reason?
Culture.
Yeah.
Leadership.
Okay. Why?
Because if leaders are not aligned, I think we may not be able to do it right now.
So who has driven this transformation? Who has started? Who has initiated?
It has gone through the leaders, but leaders have the right mindset in the right direction.
Okay.
Second thing, that inspect and adapt. They are not able to adopt, inspect and adapt. So that was going wrong and was going good. Mm-hmm. Not having proper inspection.
Not having proper inspection. Lack of
in-depth knowledge about the subject. We are transforming, but how we are transforming, we don't know. What we want to achieve, we don't know.
Maybe proper metric was not set up to assess.
Okay.
No vision.
So lots of time you will find that there are very good PMO and all those people are there. We are having lots of reports, data and everything, right? They are capturing. But still you will find that that's,
Probably we are not able to sustain.
Probably we know
that we have to get there. Yes. Get there once.
Yes.
But we are not continuing to sustain.
Yeah. Yeah, so you were talking about that, yes, at one point of time, we are getting that success, right? But that is very small. That was not whole intention of getting that transformation. If your success is for a very small point of period of time, right, that means that is not the whole intention of this transformation. You have invested that much. You are still investing lots of things on that line. But still you are not able to sustain that success. That is, something is wrong. Right? So what is this? So have you heard about continuous delivery? So what is continuous delivery?
So basically you just have your system increment ready so that you can ship it on demand.
On demand, okay. Yeah.
Frequent multiple
delivery. Frequent. What is that frequency?
It can be different on the like what somebody maybe weekly, support somebody monthly, maybe
anytime.
So when you hear continuous delivery, right? What examples comes in your mind?
Facebook.
How frequently they do that?
Every day.
Every day, how many times?
Multiple times.
Yeah, 100 times. 100 times. Google? Same. You will get similar to that. If you look at all those, you will find that yes, that is what the continuous delivery is. So as a bank, or as a healthcare domain company, right? If I will hear that, I will get encouraged. So let's go for that continuous delivery model. So can a bank or a healthcare company, right, do that frequently, releases in a day, in a week, right? And if they have tried, if they have started that entire initiative thinking that, is it possible? And why it's not possible, I will tell you. Why? Because in both the domain, they have their own regulations, which is very strict and that they have to follow. And those regulations varies from country to country. So if a small thing, if they have to roll out, it has to be rolled out in 11 countries or 11 different regions, and each region will have their own norms, regulations, which has to be followed. So you cannot do just like a single click, it will be get into the production. It's not possible.
And also, the CI is not basically it's required, it's also required, need basis, right? It's really required for the healthcare or...
Yeah, definitely. That's why I'm talking about that, your expectation and your actual, right? You have to look at. You have to look at lots of other things. You cannot just go for that, that everything, this thing is going into the market. So if you have Facebook, that like, right? If it's not working, so suppose they have pushed something into the production, it's not working, what is the impact? In your, because you guys are using social media, na? What is the impact? But suppose ICICI Bank, they have rolled out something, their transaction is half baked only. What is the impact?
We get panic.
Yes. So that way we cannot have, so we have to figure it out based upon our things, expectations and the reality. And based upon our domain, our constraint, we have to create that. If that is not we have created, we cannot get that success. It can get into that big failure. Right? So wrong expectations. That is for sure we have to correct it. And this already we have talked about. What is this?
Lead by example. Lead by example.
Not to follow but other
follow.
Not to follow but other
follow. Blind follow.
Current trend and let's follow others. Right? So that is in the market and let's go for it. Okay? So, in the same context, right, if you look at the DevOps, and if you go to any, not typically from the agile side, if you go to the DevOps related meetups, right, and if you find this type of audience, you will find more than 80% people are from what background? Ops. But less dev people will be there. They will be only talking about what? Tools. Right? And you will start hearing lots of new job opening also, like DevOps manager. Have you heard about that? DevOps architect, DevOps lead, DevOps coach. Right? So we need to understand why and what is making sense in our context. Right?
They are giving an opportunity that you can
try this way, but they are still resisting that. No, you don't want to do that.
Something
is reluctant to change.
Comfort zone.
Okay. So, then your question, right? I was looking at, and I have seen that improvised version of that particular cartoon. So the cartoon was saying that there is a guy who is asking the audience, how many of you want change? So everybody was raising the hand. How many wants to change? No. And how many wants to be part of that change? It was all left. No one was there. Right? So that is the really, really alarming thing in that case. So whether we are talking about transformation and adoption or whatever, we are talking about agile or non-agile. If any best practices are good practices are there, if you are talking about that, and if you are not ready to take that, it's not going to make sense. Right? Okay. So what is this?
Transformation.
So Ubuntu butterfly. Right? So finally what happens? We spend lots of time, lots of effort, money, people, everything for that transformation. We set our expectations, goal, vision, everything, right, into place. We put effort, right, 1 year, 6 months, 2 years, and finally we find that we are reaching to this. And we feel that, yeah, we've transformed. And we come to this type of conference and we give our case study, we tell that this is what we have done, that is what I have done. And we try to spread that message. People take that message, getting again encouraged, going back to their place, start doing that. Right? And what happens? Ain't that the end? So let's look at what is next. So after transformation, few months later, the same case study, go back. Is it possible? Organization is possible. This is not possible. Right, once the cocoon has become butterfly, it cannot again become that bug, cocoon and so on. But the tea, yes, or the organization, yes, right? So why? Why it happens?
We are unable to sustain,
that's correct. We are not interested to learn further. Yeah, of course. See, I will tell you one thing. If you look at our team, is has started that sprint, right? Or Scrum model they have taken, suppose. And they are having that grooming meeting, they are having all the rituals, whatever is there. You will find after transformation also, when I am saying that, they are going back to this stage, old. It does not mean that they are not doing that. Still they are doing. They are having those space, they are having Scrum Master. If you ask, they will say that we have product backlog, we are having PO, everything is there. And lots of time you will find that as a external guy, if you will go there, you will find that yes, they are already transformed. Are they performing? That's the question. The whole transformation is for performing, right? Is it happening really?
I think it becomes like IPL. Like IPL, similar to IPL, like transmission.
IPL is a different issue with IPL. So what happens, as I told you, if you go there and they will be claiming that we are already agile, we know agile, we are doing a Scrum, right? All those things they will say. So they, what they will have? Really Scrum?
It's more of compliance, not agile.
compliance, not the effectiveness. That's correct, you say?
Correct.
So mostly it's just a ritual.
We do agile. Doing agile.
Yes, we do agile. We do agile. Have you, as a part of team, have you felt that after certain sprint, you are feeling that retrospective is over it? Do you feel that? Right? Or do you feel that why we are coming to our daily scrum? Daily. Why can't?
It happens if the retrospective out of points has been given that has not been taken care, then you feel like no, there is no point in the
retrospective.
Right. 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 So, you have to take the action.
So that is one thing which is actually pushing you towards once again to that old stage. And you will be just like a making sure that you are having all those checklists maintained at your end. So the moment you will say that your scrum master has left the organization, they will hire another new scrum master. Right? The new job opening will come, scrum master, csar.net. Have you seen that? I don't want to name that company, but I have seen that and I was really wondering, how come a scrum master csar.net?
But the reason is probably many organizations today want their scrum masters to also ask the right technical questions to the team, keep bugging the team on the technicalities and so on. So for that reason, they want someone to come rather than
That's why I'm giving you that example. Right? And that's not a good example. In fact, it's for the other side. Right? Another thing is, if you go and ask your team member, why do you do that? What the answer they will say? You are already there, we don't know. Yes, we are. Right? Doing without knowing is more dangerous. Right? If you are not, if you are knowing and you are doing, then it's okay. Somehow you know, maybe you can correct it. If you don't know and you are doing, that is more dangerous. So what should we do in that case? How to sustain it? Any idea? Any thought? And don't wait for my slides.
Any new person who joins the team that's already there, you effectively hire the right fit or you train that person and you change mindset to transform him or her?
That's what. So once you have transformed, you came back then.
We need to motivate the team somehow.
You need to motivate the team.
So that they don't leave.
Okay, you're retraining maybe.
Okay. Any specific thing you can just think about from your own perspective, what will make you not to leave?
Promotion.
Forget about that other thing.
Show them why.
Yeah.
Keeps going back to
why.
Keeps
why means what? Okay, fine. Yeah.
We have practice. Drink the water, right? And if you're taking the water in the light or dark, it's unfortunate we do that actually.
I got your point. So what he's saying should be in your habit. Yeah. It should be in your habit in such a way that it should be always like this. So yeah, like how you are drinking water in light or without or with light, right? So you can have it. And that type of habit you should have. Sometimes I give this example. If you are going just after my this session, you will go and have tea. You will ask. Then you will ask tea. You will say yes, tea. And if you will ask with or without cup. Right? So if I will say, you can just use this anywhere. So if I will say product, give me product with or without quality. Do the development with or without TDD, with or without testing. No, it's by default when I'm saying product, it's a quality product. You have not to mention explicitly that we will give you high quality product. Right? So product means it should be based upon my expectation. That's it. Right? So one thing is, once you have transformed, there are lots of things which we need to keep alive within the team or the organization. What is happening here?
Continuous education.
So one thing, what we have to do, whether it's the new team or the old team, right? So we have to plan regular orientation sessions based upon the need. And that we have to keep doing that. Now, if you have lots of people together who have joined recently, you can have that induction session, which will be the part of your organizational culture, that's correct. But suppose you are a small team, and one person has joined you, then what you will do? You cannot ask for an orientation session for this much big room will be there, and he will be sitting there, and one trainer will come and he will explain. So what can be done in that case?
We take
them for some 15 minutes. So as a team only, you need to guide him, tell him what we do and how, why we do that, why we feel that it's a value. We can have one-to-one as well, if the entire team cannot spend time. Right? That way, at least we will make sure that whoever is coming as a new is getting into the same understanding. So when I am saying something, just like that, if I am saying tea, I am saying it with cup. You, once you have joined, you also understand that it's right. Just imagine that somebody, TK, that guy has come, some alien has come, right? He does not know tea itself. So cup and other things are totally different for him. Right? So you have to make sure that he understands what you are actually going to do, what we are talking about. Right? So that's very, very important when we are talking about. One is the regular orientation sessions and as per the need. Right? Okay, this is a little bit on technical side. So I ask these questions very regularly to all the developers. Do you know Sachin Tendulkar?
Yes.
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 How good he is in the batting?
Good?
Very good. Okay, fine. But suppose if he has to go to play a match, what he does before that?
He practice.
But he's a great batsman.
But he's still practice.
He still practice. So from the singer side also, if you look at, or any musician, right? If you look at there also, before going to any musical concert, they practice, daily they practice. As a developer, do we practice? And I'm not talking about learning new tools. I'm just talking about, they are not learning their new techniques, they are practicing. Do we developers practice? Yes, of course we practice. Where? Live code, production code. We practice and we fail there only. Right? And that's why what I say, you have to practice. So what they can do, and that's what we were telling them, that you should be having a habit that when you are drinking, whether in the light or not, you should be able to take properly, right? Same way, with TDD, without TDD, I don't understand. When I will start, I will write test cases, I will do the development. That's my habit. I will never say that, okay, you want this, you just show it to be done with TDD or without TDD. I will never ask. And that will be in my practice. And time to time we can have internally for our team, weekly, every week, let's go sit together, take any problem, right, which could be very generic. And we will use all that required practices. Now tell me one thing, lots of time what happens, we say that, yes, we are not doing TDD or we are not doing any other things, maybe it's a debatable, people say that it takes lots of time. If I will go with the TDD, I need more time, right? So I'm not going into that particular debate, but I'm taking your point as well. So if you are not doing it, but do you know how to do a development using TDD approach? Do we know that? And then we are at that situation, we have diverted. first we should be able to do that. Yeah.
Okay. So here also I have two hands.
Not worry.
Okay, so that's the thing. So we have to practice it. It should be. Why we have to use this martial arts people?
Have you heard about dojo, coding dojo or coding kata? So the coding dojo or coding kata is just a technical session where the developers, they work together in a pair programming mode and they try to solve a problem using all clean code, the TDD and all those approaches together, they try to solve that, right? Martial art people also do that. Daily they practice. Same thing they do. But why they practice? When they go for an actual battle, right? And if somebody has kicked, if they will start thinking, okay, if he has kicked it from here, what I should do? Till that time, what will happen? Right? So the same thing, it should be in your habit. So I'm writing, oh, I should use that refactoring here, or I should do this. You should not. It should get in your habit. You should start thinking, okay, I will write this method. And then I will just, whatever. And that way you will start evolving that. That should come into your culture. So we have to learn by doing lots of things, new practices. And as well as we have to practice. Right? That platform we have to create within the organization, within the team. If you are only concerned about the team, we have to build that culture. Right? That is one thing. Next thing is, so how many times we as an individual learn something and we keep that secret with us? Next time if something is there, they will say that go to that person, he will tell you how to do, because he has done that. Why? Because he is a star performer. And if that guy is not there, for due to any reason, maybe he is on vacation, the entire team is waiting once he will come back and then he will do that. Right? So that should not happen. What we have to do? We have to create a platform where the people come. And it should be again in the regular frequency, it's not as per the need. It should be every week and it will be driven by the team. So I have learned something, I have done something in my case. Let's share that thing with others. And we say in a different way. So sometimes people say, right? So we have, people can club together and they can just talk about that. Suppose in some time you are not finding any topic, you have not done something, every week maybe you have not done something new, then also you can run a book club. You can identify a book, read that one practice, and try it out. Right? You can try in the production portals. Right? So the basic idea is connect, learn, share, and grow together. Right? We are hearing lots of things in this, like inspect and adapt. What is this? How it's going to help you sustaining the transformation, is it? So inspect and adapt in a way, like suppose you are finding that this is not, you are not feeling that it's adding any value. Like how I have given you that example of retrospect. So you cannot stop that. You have to think about how can we make it as more effective. Is there any other way to make it as more effective? You can talk with the other team as well. You can find out why it's not effective. Right? And that is where you have to just take that measurement. If you will stop doing those things, probably the team will start feeling that it's just a checklist. We are not doing for a right reason. We are talking something else, we are doing something else. Right? And what is very important, periodically perform self-assessment. You can have various ways to do the self-assessment. Right? The same example like retrospect. And some gentleman has told that maybe because no one is caring about the action items. Right? So in that case, if you will go for the self-assessment like a checklist, do you do that retrospect? Yes, certainly what you will say. No, you can ask that what were your, in this has been, what are your action items from your last retrospective? Do the team knows? Do you have the list of action items from your last retrospective? Where is it? Are you maintaining somewhere? Is it visible to everyone? Everyone knows and aware of that? Trust. within the team, if you look, go and ask in this particular, like this forum, you will ask, do you trust each other? What they will say? Will they say no? Anyone? No. Go for the secret ballot. I will tell you, you will get that real answer. So lots of time you have to do that assessment in a different way. And you have to find out where are the issues which needs to be found. Now how you will find them could be another thing that we need to look at. Right? And the last but not least, who is this guy? The star performer? Superman? Scrum Master? So, to keep driving these things, these good things within the organization or across the team, we need people, right? So identify and groom internal change agents because they will help you to keep driving this particular transformation. It will be keep continuing. If those guys are not there, it's not going to work out. It can be, Scrum Master can be part of one of the change agents, but only they cannot be a change agent, for sure. Then again, you will try to find out a Scrum Master with C# and .NET. Right? So, that's the whole thing is. And that's the reason, if you are feeling that you have reached the transformation stage, so you have just started your journey, your transformation journey, it will keep going on, right? And that's why we are saying it's not destination, it's a journey. We can't say that we have stopped it, okay? But my talk will stop.